श्रीमती रामानुजाय नमः। श्रीमान् वेंकटनाथार्य कवितार्किक केसरी वेदांताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि। श्रीमते निगमांत महादेशिकाय नमः। श्रीमते आदिवंचट गोपयतींद्र महादेशिकाय नमः। हाय किड्स, टुडे लेट मी टेक दिस ऑपर्चुनिटी टू नैरेट द स्टोरी ऑफ ग्रेट श्री वेदांत देशिका, who is prime torch bearer of Sri Ramanuja's heritage on the occasion of his 752nd birthday. In Kanchipuram, one of the seven temple towns where one can attain salvation, there was Ananta Somayaji of Vishwamitra Gotram, who was one of the 74 Simhasanadipatis nominated by Sri Ramanuja. His son was Pundarika Yajwa. His son was Ananta Suri. Pundarika Yajwa approached Appullar and requested to give the later sister Totaramba in marriage to his son Anantasuri. Appullar was belonging to the vamsham of Atreya Ramanuja Kadambi Achan, who was so much caring towards Sri Ramanuja and hence was selected to be Sri Ramanuja's personal chef, which is a separate story on its own. That night, Lord Devaraja appeared in the dream of Appullar and seconded the proposal, saying that by this marriage will be born one would be a multi-fields talented person who would establish and protect Sri Ramanuja's heritage. After that, the marriage of Anantasuri and Totaramba happened. As ordered by Lord Srinivasa and Padmavidit Dayar of Tirupati, the couple went on a pilgrimage to Tirumalai. The Lord appeared in their dreams in the form of a Sri Vaishnava youth and handed over a small golden temple bell, which Todarambha swallowed. Next morning, when they discussed with each other, they were astonished to find how both of them had the same dream, which concurred in every detail. As the priest opened the doors of the sanctum sanctorum, he found the bell missing. During an investigation ordered into the loss of the bell, the Lord appeared in Avesha, spiritual trance, on Tirumalai Nambi and told that he had himself presented the bell to Anantasuri couple, and thenceforward the small hand bell need not be used in the Tiruvaradhana puja in the temple. Even today, when the Naivedyam variety of prasadams are offered to the Lord, it is only the huge bell suspended in front hall near Garudan Sannadhi that is being rung. 12 years after this incident, a kid was born to the couple in the year 1268 AD in the Tamil month Purattasi in the star Shravanam. His maternal uncle Appullar named him as Venkatanathan. One day, Appullar took the boy, who was then hardly 5 years of age, with him to attend Shribhashya Kala Kshepam, spiritual class of Nadadur Ammal. Nadadur Ammal was so impressed with the captivating brilliance of the kid that he stopped the discourse to exchange pleasantries. Later, when he tried to resume the discourse, Nadadur Ammal was fumbling as to the context where he left off. Our Venkatanathan reminded him of the context. Nadadur Ammal was overwhelmed and took the boy on his lap, hugged him and blessed him. "You will establish Vedanta on a firm footing, demolishing the misrepresentations of other faiths." At the age of 7, Upanayanam was performed for him. He learned Vedas, Puranas and various Vedic scriptures. By the age of 20, he became a well-respected person by all. At the age of 21, he married Kanakavalli. Venkatanathan used to perform all his daily duties, Aupasana homams and pujas, daily as prescribed by scriptures. He lived by Unchavritti, begging for grains, true to the norms prescribed. One day, he came back home with grains gathered and observed some gold coin. He said to give it to someone or throw it. Appullar taught Garuda Mantra to Desika. Desika went to Tiruvahindrapuram near Kadalur in Tamil Nadu in India and climbed Aushadagiri Hill, sat under an Ashwatha tree and performed penance towards Garuda, meditating Garuda Mantra. Pleased with Desika's penance, Garuda appeared before him and taught him Hayagriva Mantra. Then Desika did penance towards Lord Hayagriva, and after some months, Lord Hayagriva appeared before him, blessed him, fed him with the nectar flowing from his mouth, and presented a Hayagriva Vigraha to Desika. Lord Hayagriva took his seat on the tip of the tongue of Vedanta Desika as prayed by him. Of the many details, of the many deities Desika sang about, Devanatha of Tiruvahindrapuram is the only one who has been praised in three languages, Sanskrit, Prakrit and Tamil. Swami himself catalogues all his works on Devanatha in the following Tamil verse. Andamil sir ayindanagaramandanadan adinimel adiurayalaimbadetti sindhaigavar prakritam nooruguri shalandamil mummani kovai seriya serthu பந்து கழலம்மானை ஊசலேசல் பரவு நவமணி மாலை இவையும் சொன்னேன் முந்தமரை வழி மொழிய வழிமொழி நீ என்று முகுந்தனருள் தந்த பயன் பெற்றேன் நானே. லார்ட் வரதராஜா பிளஸ் தேசிகா வித் அன் இல்லுஸ்ட்ரியஸ் சன் வரதாரியா. ஹீ ஃபாலோட் தி ஃபுட் ஸ்டெப்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ் இல்லுஸ்ட்ரியஸ் ஃபாதர் அண்ட் ஷோன் லைக் எ லேம்ப் லிட் ஃப்ரம் அனதர் லேம்ப். The Sri Hayagriva Vigraha, which was originally worshipped by Goddess Saraswati and handed over by her to Sri Ramanuja, was being subsequently worshipped by Tirukurugai Piran Pillan and Pundarikaksha. This Pundarikaksha was the son-in-law of Appullar and was working as Rajaguru of Rayar Samastanam. As ordered by the Lord Srinivasa, Pundarikaksha handed over the Sri Hayagriva Vigraha to Vedanta Desika with royal honors in Kanchipuram. A magician confronted Desika and challenged him. As the magician drank the water of a pond, Desika's stomach bulged, filled with water and caused unbearable pain. Desika meditated a mantra and just scratched with his fingernail a pillar nearby, and all the water flowed out there from the and Desika's belly regained the normal position. The magician begged to be excused and disappeared, but not before the Swami thanking him for helping in cleaning the streets of Kanchipuram without any effort on his part. In 1323 AD, Malikapur invaded Srirangam. Citizens of Srirangam tried to protect but could not manage Delhi Sultan's huge army headed by Army General Malikapur. At that time, Sri Vedanta Desika was in Srirangam and he was 54 years old. Understanding the situation, Vedanta Desika, who is a highly versatile person in many arts, constructed a stone wall like a screen with his own hand at the entrance Kulasekara Padi of Lord Ranganatha's Garbhagraha Sanctum Sanctorum. He also made all arrangements for Lord Ranganatha Vigraha to travel out of Srirangam through a secret tunnel within the temple. Vedanta Desika took Sudarshana Bhattar's two sons and the manuscripts of Shruta Prakashika, the elaborate commentary of Sri Bhashyam chronicled by Sudarshana Bhattar during the Kalakshepam's spiritual class of Nadadur Ammal, to safety at Thirunarayanapuram in Karnataka in India via Satyamangalam. But before he could do that, the Muslim army attacked them and massacred many of them. Swami hid himself with few others in the midst of corpses and spent the night. In the morning, they moved towards Satyamangalam and from there to Satyagalam village in Karnataka, en route to Thirunarayanapuram in Karnataka. A snake charmer brought a few snakes and asked Desika if he could control them. Desika drew a line on the floor with a piece of chalk. The serpents could not cross the line, but when a highly poisonous snake crossed and threateningly advanced towards him, he uttered the Garuda mantra. Immediately, a Garuda bird appeared and picked up all the serpents and flew away. Deprived of his only means of livelihood, the snake charmer begged to be excused. Desika recited his Garuda Dantakam and the bird brought back the snakes. That's the partial story of greatness of Swami Vedanta Desika. Thank you all. We will meet with the next part of the story soon. Stay tuned.